Miracle Girl Ford. This is my first full year in Nextel Cup competition. I'm having a great time. I'm kind of a rookie, I guess. I ran 14 races last season and not eligible for Rookie of the Year honors, but I feel like a rookie. Atlanta, that was just so exciting. I mean, to win that race on the last lap, passing Jimmy Johnson, I couldn't believe what was happening. When I'm not racing, I just love to spend time outdoors, anything. Mountain biking, riding my dirt bike, going fishing if I've got time. And it's definitely fishing in my case. It's not a lot of catching. I usually just sit there on the bank and eat some lures.
Oh, look at this.
But I had a good time, Jim. I was a substitute school teacher for a little while, and I'd say some of those kids got back at me for all the trouble I gave my teachers when I was a kid. Yeah, I like to play guitar, but anytime your own mother tells you to quit singing, it's a bad sign. So I just play. I don't sing at all.
Good advice to the man with a persistent smile, the Atlanta winner, Carl Edwards. Now, we told you cars that stayed out because they'd already pitted under green are ahead of him on the back end of the lead lap. So Edwards, our race leader, number 99, will start mid-pack. This is car owner Jack Roush. The cat in the hat is rated his straw fedora for an Army helmet. Here we go.
Carl Edwards in the 99.
Was Rusty Wallace in front of him, and somebody up in front of him did, Larry, and caused him to about run over somebody.
Now Rusty goes way up the racetrack.
I think it was Rusty that actually had the problem, and he was smoking.
George
smoking.
George has a lot of damage to the left foot. I think he's starting to stack it up behind Rusty.
Yeah.
All back in the field.
I mean, all night long, sooner or later, he's going to have a rotten restart.
Yeah. Well, Tony Stewart came on the radio and said he had a meeting with
corner. We had just bragged about the Gibbs boys had kind of turned it around tonight. Right, Joe Gibbs, two cars, Bobby Labonte and Tony Stewart, restarted third and fourth. They had not yet pitted when the caution flag came out. Boy, he's going to have to be careful trying to get the pit road with all these cars behind him. I think he would have liked to have come to pit road then, but I'm not sure he can with all these cars right up behind him.
And of course, his big hope is that we get a caution, he'd be able to stay on the lead lap, but he may did not come to pit road.
That'd be my concern. 37 laps to go.
You see Scott Rigg there in the 10 car. Remember, he restarted second position in the race, but he's down a cylinder. He couldn't go anywhere. Looks like Stewart may come to pit road now. We have a battle for lead, though. The Army, the 01 car. Don't even get to the inside of Carl Edwards in the 99.
But Edwards has the preferred line in 1 and 2, the line that was ground in that middle groove, and he holds Nemechek off for the moment. I think that Joe's got the preferred line in 3 and 4, though. The bottom is good down here. He should be able to make the pass. Carl's just hanging in there, but
But why those dogs are battling? Look at that 18 car, Bobby LeBonte.
Here comes Stewart to pit road. I think he was just waiting to get everybody out from behind him, Larry. I know he'd like to get down there, but I don't think he could.
Well, he didn't really say anything from behind the wheel, and then all of a sudden he just got on the radio and said, I think he needs to be evicted, and he is, and they're trying to pull the fender out now to get him back on the racetrack, but he's not going to have the great finish tonight that he might otherwise have had if this hadn't occurred.
So Coke falls off the lead lap as Nemechek grabs the lead from Carl Edwards and now tries to put Jarrett down once again. Jarrett, the 88 on the tail end of the lead lap. Ooh,
little bump draft in the middle of the straightaway. You can hear the RPMs go up on Dale Jarrett's car.
That wasn't bump draft, that was bump get out of my way.
Bobby Labonte goes by Carl Edwards in the 99 for second, but caution is on the Speedway for the 20th time tonight.
Got a car stall down here. It's Dave Blaney.
But now that will put all those cars that were out in front of our leader, Joe Nemechek, that will put them back.
Look over in turn two. Look at Dale Jarrett.
Dale Jarrett, 88.
Look at that.
No, he does not like what went on right there.
And I suppose he did that.
He'll be back up.
Now, Jarrett.
Four, five, let's hang on with those here after the race. We get a car.
if he keeps doing that. Caution out for Dave Blaney, and this time a NASCAR Grand National Winston Cup, Nextel Cup record. 20 caution flags in one race. We've also had a Coca-Cola 600 record with 20 different leaders of this race.
Now this will allow Jimmy Johnson, the 48, Kenny McMurray, the 42, Greg Biffle, the 16, Jeff Gordon, the 24, Kevin Harvick, the 29, Elliott Stadler, the 38, Mark Martin, the 6, Jeremy Mayfield, in the 19.
Hammer, Granny, we got first big damage down the right side.
We'll be back on the lead lap.
Here's what led to that disagreement. Remember Richmond in the Busch race when Jared's teammate Elliott Stadler got bumped out of the lead on the last lap by Carl Edwards. I think Carl may have been giving him a bump draft. I don't think DJ appreciated it or whatever it was. DJ to say, hey dude, this is under caution. You hit my car. So I'm going to hit yours.
Dale Jarrett has a lot of left front damage, it looks like. Left front fender damage, and he will be the free pass car. He'll be back on the lead lap.
He's going to have to come to pit road, I think.
Back on that restart. Everyone got jacked up. The 99 of Edwards has knocked a hole in the grill. You can see the damage in that grill area. Now the car is tight.
Can't play bumper cars with these cars. They're pretty fragile.
Not a deep speed. He hurt a lot of the front downforce there. Plus, he could have a cooling issue.
Now, if he stopped with all these cars that came around on the lead lap, he would restart about 24. But see, you can't do that here. And you can call that a rookie mistake or whatever you want to call it, but you just can't do that here. Well, it's one thing, Darrell, when you're first and second and you're kind of bump trapping.
Yeah,
Darrell knows he's the last car on the lead lap. He's trying to stay on the lead lap. This is not Daytona. This is not Talladega. This is Charlotte. And you can't bump draft at Charlotte. To stay in front of you, stay on the lead lap.
Now, almost all of those cars, including Jeff Gordon in the 24, Jimmy Johnson here in the 48, back on the lead lap, all have elected to come to pit road. More tires and adjustments here with about 31 laps to go.
And see what Carl Edwards has probably done with that grill being knocked out. He has beaten himself. Crew chiefs are saying, be patient. This is what they're talking about. Be patient with Dale Jarrett. Don't tear your car up. He's a lap down, for Pete's sake. While racing Jonina check for the lead, Carl Edwards gets in the back of Dale Jarrett and may have cost himself a chance to win.